quite a few decathlons have been won and lost on that. Then the discus, then the pole vault, which usually takes hours and hours and hours, but is one of the highlights as far as the crowd is concerned for the decathlon. Then the javelin, then of course 3 3/4 laps of the track, the 1500 meters to finish the second day. And decathletes will be warming up, and there's the main man. It was supposed to be the Dan and Dave show 4 years ago. Dan O'Brien here, the world record holder, and Dave Johnson. There was a massive publicity campaign, something like $20 million spent on that. Dan O'Brien didn't make the Olympic team. So we can see the result of that first heat in just a few moments' time. But as you can see, the Olympic flag down at the far end of the stadium there, a little bit of wind, but the wind reading on the stadium after that last heat was only about plus point 0.3 meters per second, so ideal conditions. So here we come with the start list for the next heat.
Azarov, drawn on the inside, the Estonian, Penalva of Spain, Winter of Australia, Ganiev of Uzbekistan, Shmara of Poland, Zabo of Hungary, Pickets of Latvia, or Picks rather, of Latvia, and Rosendahl of the Netherlands. Just to remind you that the false start situation changes in this decathlon. As you were saying, it was very shaky at the start of that last one. You're out on the third in decathlon, which is only fair. Two normally. No outstanding competitor, although Penalva was the silver medalist 4 years ago, but his best total this season, 8.044. Got a best over the 100 meters of 10.76. Goes back a fair way. We've seen a fair bit of him. Nazarov, 10.71 this season, 14th in the last Olympic Championship. Penalva, we've mentioned, finalist in many of the major decathlons over the last 5 or 6 years. Peter Winter, the Australian, 10.76 to his credit. Peter Winter, in lane four, representing the second 8.084, a total for the season. Ganiev, Uzbekistan, former champion. He was eighth last Olympic final. His wind assisted from 9.43 this season. A pole. Tamara didn't finish in the World Championships last year. He did get over in the World Student or World University Games last season. 8.113 is total over the 10 events this season. It's more relevant to give this season's totals rather than overall and lifetime best. Zabo, 8.436. 10.86 is best in the Olympic final. Physics, the Latvian, he's the Latvian decathlon record holder. He didn't finish in the World Championships last season. Rosendahl of the Netherlands, 8.080. It's that's 1996 total overall. And nothing desperately outstanding in terms of overall totals for the season, but then this is what they call this particular occasion. And we could always remember watching Daley Thompson over that first event saying, well, you know, to get near that personal best was so vital to set you up for the rest of the day. And to falter here when you're in medal contention, even by the odd tenth or so, would be a bit disconcerting, and it puts pressure on late on. That was Nazarov of Estonia. One false start. Just looking down there, he's got a very heavy strapping, the Estonian, which indicates that not all is entirely well. Just trying to get that extra, just a few hundredths of a second. Because, let me repeat, times equate to pots on a decathlon table. And everyone here, or someone will come first in this race, and someone will come last. I know that sounds obvious, but man coming in at the end will want to be as quick as possible to get his vital points onto the card, because his strength may come later in the decathlon. And he needs every little bit of help he can. athletes will be coming fourth and fifth in these really time trials, and yet they'll be setting personal bests. Well, that looked like to Rosenthal, the Dutchman on the near side, and very edgy and shaky on this heat. And it's a bit disconcerting because seeing it in the individual 100 meters, that once there's such a long hold up, then that's confirmed. Such a long hold up, eventually the athletes can go a little bit flat mentally, and they lose a little bit of edge. You've got to be very strong to maintain that height of readiness, if you like, mental readiness. Penalva, so experienced, settles down again. So Nazarov, the Estonian in the inside lane, has had one false start. Rosendahl of the Dutton in the outside lane has had one false start. Individual battles against the stopwatch about to begin. Very shaky, it's a very long hold, I must say, and very unsteady. I wonder whether someone might get a false start reading from that, because pressure of blocks here triggers off the whole system, and Penalva looked as though he was acknowledging that. Well, one thing's back, Stuart, to 1988 in Seoul. Well, one of the favorites, Jürgen Hingson, was disqualified for committing false starts, but certainly Penalva there appeared to be coming out of his blocks. Looking at the pole, and less than happy, so here we go once again. Penalva doing his best to concentrate in this opening event. Absolutely perfect. Looks to be a slight following breeze. The Olympic flag is anything to go by. Away this time. Third lane winter of Australia going well outside him. Ganyev was a bit as it can, and on the near side. And for Shamara, but it was, we'll bring you up to date with that in a moment, but the winning time 10.85, and Atyanyev got off pretty well. He was eighth in the last Olympic final, and Wynn got off well too, and each one of those athletes will turn now and look at the board, and they'll wait for the result to come up, and they'll know the score all the way. Ganyev and Szabo and Penalva, individual tallies there. They are the first four. Uzbekistan have a good competitor here. It's best of 10.74, so it's just outside of that. Winter went well side. He's a 10.76 man. Near side, Szabo going well, and Penalva. Those four, Ganyev just getting the advantage. And the rest will wait, and then they'll compare those times with the scorebook. A race against self, against the clock. Only just Ganyev over winter, wasn't it? Well, this is Ante Penalva, the man who won the silver medal in Barcelona. Fantastic atmosphere there was in the Olympic Stadium when this guy was running around the last event, the 1500 meters. He's very tall, very, very good thrower indeed. And I think, to be fair to him, that was a decathlon of his life in Barcelona. He hasn't really managed to repeat that performance. But as you can see, these guys are a lot broader in the shoulder than most sprinters. A lot of them have got very, very muscular arms. Their range of training in preparation for decathlon is remarkable. Lifting very heavy weights, a lot of sprinting. Anyway, we can bring you up to date with the result of Heat 1. It was Victor Houston of Barbados who came through very, very quickly. 10.76 seconds. He really is a runner jumper. I think he might find difficulty when it comes to shot put and discus. Marcel Dost there, 10.75 seconds, just outside his personal performance. And in third place, the Italian record holder, Pozzarina, 11.05. Well, most of the decathletes are off the warm-up track now, and this is the undercover area. Dan O'Brien looking very relaxed. And a man who is destined to win the Olympic gold medal. I suppose you have to say that of a man who's won the World Championships three times in a row and is the world record holder. A lot of talk, of course, in terms of barrier breaking. 9,000.